take this opportunity to welcome the friends and the family who have gathered together today to celebrate the love that has been found between two people. You've been invited to share with Jezyrose and Darryl a very important moment in their lives today. In the time that they have been together, their love and understanding of each other has grown and it's matured, and it's led them to arrive at this moment today, where they'll begin together the journey of living their lives as husband and wife. As we witness this moment, would you please join me in bowing your heads as we ask God to bless this day. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for the opportunity, Lord, to be in this place, God, to celebrate the love that has been found between Jezzy and Darryl. And God, we ask, Lord, that you would just be here with us in this moment. God, as they look to you for strength and guidance, as they take this journey together as husband and wife, we ask that your hand would be upon them, that you would encourage them, strengthen them, and lead them all the days of their life. Father, we give you glory and honor and praise. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. It's with great joy and great excitement for Jezzy and Darryl that we've come together to celebrate today this union in marriage. And to this special moment, they bring the fullness of their hearts as a treasure and a gift from God to share with one another. And together, they're going to bring all their dreams, which bind them together in a lifetime of commitment. They also bring their friendship. They bring their gifts, their talents, as well as their unique personalities, which God will continue to unite together as one as they build their lives together. Today, we also celebrate a covenant of love and of loyalty made between two people. And Jezzy and Darryl make that covenant as they have come into this relationship with eyes wide open, acknowledging the hard work and journey that it has taken to arrive at this moment, as well as the hard work, the determination, and committing to an exclusive love and loyalty and moving forward. Scripture teaches us that God saw that it was not good for man to live alone, so he created woman and gave her to him to be his companion, to be his friend, to be his wife. And the Lord said, "Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one." And in understanding this, I'd like to ask, who gives this woman to be married to this man? We do. Thank you so much, Darryl. This marriage that you have come to be united in today is a good thing, created by God for your fulfillment and enjoyment as well as companionship. Marriage, however, is also the work of God revealing himself to us and his love for us. Marriage is more than an event that happens on one important day. It's deeper than all the physical things that we experience today, for your marriage is incredibly spiritual. But the intimacy and the friendship and the closeness that a man and a woman share in marriage is an example, an object lesson, teaching us about an even greater love that Christ has shown to us. There's so much to be said of love. We understand that real and true love simply means an unconditional commitment to an imperfect person. That's what God has done for us. Love is also a word, though, that carries so much impact that it's often hard to define it. Someone said that love wants to give, and because it does, its primary goal is just to simply make the other happy. That would mean that love is the desire to please one another. It's a passionate and ongoing desire on the part of two people to produce together, yet still spontaneously express their individuality within the context of marriage. We understand that love is also the soil and the climate which each of you can flourish, and it's far superior to anything that you two could ever achieve alone or on your own. But understand, there can be no true and genuine love without trust. And trust is that which is willing to accept risks. Risks like sharing with each other your life, your thoughts, your goals, and your dreams. The Apostle Paul in 1 Corinthians 13 says this of love. He says that love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. He says that love, it never fails. This doesn't mean that love is gullible or that love is blind or that love just has no point, but it does mean that love possesses an attitude of complete trust. Also, love is a commitment that says, we'll never give up. It stays until the finish. Remember what it said in 1 Corinthians 13, that love bears all things, it endures all things, that love, it never fails. Love abides, it stays. It has a stick-to-itiveness that no matter what, real love has a commitment quality that is willing to continue to persevere and to fine-tune the marriage relationship. Love is not a blind emotion, but it's an act of will. It's a firm decision. It's a commitment to one another to make your marriage work and to last a lifetime. The crucial thing, however, about love is that true and lasting love, it only comes by the help of God himself. We can't do this on our own. We need his help. And the good news is that the Apostle John tells us that love is of God, that God is love. And because God first loved us, it gives us the capacity to love one another. In fact, John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life." This is real love. And this is the kind of marriage that we desire to establish. The kind of marriages that we want to build a foundation on are those where there are two lives being drawn together by a holy and greater love, much bigger than their own, because we understand that if God be for us, then who could ever be against us? Darryl, I'd like to ask, having considered the privilege and obligations of this marriage, do you believe that it's the will of God and the sincere desire of your heart that you and Jezzy become husband and wife and share the rest of your days together?
I do.
Thank you. Jezzy, I would like to ask you, as you consider the privilege and obligations of this marriage, do you believe that it's the will of God, as well as the sincere desire of your heart that you and Darryl become husband and wife and spend the rest of your days together?
I do.
Thank you. Today, over the next few moments, both Jezzy and Darryl are going to symbolically unite their lives together. There's several ways that that is going to take place. One is a significant practice that is often a cultural practice. It's a significant wedding tradition. It's known as the cord and veil. The veil simply symbolizes the oneness of marriage. It also represents the couple being clothed as one, being found pure before God, covered in his protection. Cord also symbolizes the unbreakable bonds of marriage. The cord symbolizes this lifetime of unity and the everlasting union of this bride and this groom together today as they officially become husband and wife. It's significant because the cord is shaped in an infinity. It symbolizes that there is a bond of lasting love that should never, ever end. So today, as we take part in that, I believe you guys are going to be seated this moment. As we share this moment together, I would like to invite the godparents, Pastor Soy and Amy, to come forward. I'd like to invite the two of you to take the cord and veil from the table. And I would love to invite you, those friends and family that are here, to just take into this moment, understanding the significance of the uniting of Darryl and Jezzy. To the friends and family that are here, I'd like to invite you in this moment just to share a time of prayer with us. And the way that we symbolically do that is we just choose to lift our hand and extend it towards Darryl and Jezzy as together we ask God's blessing upon their marriage. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for Darryl and Jezzy. God, we thank you for who you've created them to be. And Father, we thank you, God, that you are uniting them together as husband and wife today. Father, I pray, God, that in this moment, Lord God, with this cord and veil, that it'd be much more, Lord, than just something of cultural significance. But Father, I pray that it would be something, Lord God, that is etched upon their heart. Lord, a love and a unity, Lord, and a bond, Lord, that is brought together by you. Father, I pray your blessings upon them, God. I pray that you would give them strength. Lord, as they take next steps forward as a husband and wife, Lord, I pray, God, that they would work together as one, united together as husband and wife, as friends, Lord God, but also, Lord God, as your children who love you, who have been called by you, God, and are choosing to answer that call. And so, Father, we thank you, Lord, for all that you have in store for their life. We thank you that you are with them, God. And we thank you that you are active and at work in and through their lives. And so we entrust this marriage into your hands. And it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Darryl and Jezzy together today will also symbolize their unity in marriage through the lighting of a unity candle. What you see here before you today are two separate flames. And one is symbolic of Jezzy. Jezzy, it speaks to all that you were before today, all that you are, and all that you will ever be, as well as the faith and the wisdom and love that you have received from your family. The other flame represents you, Darryl. It too speaks of who you were, who you are, and who you will be, as well as the faith and wisdom and love that you have received from your family. And as the two lights come together today, they're going to come together as one. The individual lights will no longer exist, for they will be joined together. And as one light burns together before God, so should your love for one another forever be. Likewise, because of your faith in Jesus, you guys have chosen to begin your new journey in marriage today through the act of communion or the sacrament of communion. You're choosing to make Jesus number one in your life, in your relationship, in your family, as well as your new home. And as followers of Jesus, communion is an object lesson that represents a great spiritual truth. And through taking communion, Jezzy and Darryl acknowledge Jesus' death on the cross for their sins, as well as his resurrection from the grave that grants them, by faith in Jesus, forgiveness, restoration, and new life. Scriptures teach in 1 Corinthians 11, 23 through 26, Paul says, "For this is what the Lord himself said, and I pass it on as just as I received it to you. On the night when he was betrayed, the Lord Jesus took the loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and he said, 'This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way, he took the cup of wine after supper, saying, 'This is the cup of the new covenant between God and you, sealed by the shedding of my blood. Do this in remembrance of me, and as often as you drink it. For every time you eat of this bread and drink of this cup, you're announcing the Lord's death until he comes once again.'" And Darryl and Jezzy, I'd like to invite you on this journey together for taking.
I love you, Lord. Day and night, night and day, let incense arise. Day and night, night and day, let incense arise. Day and night, night and day, let incense arise. Day and night, night and day, let incense arise. Day.
Darryl, and Jezzy both, I want you to just to take a moment to just kind of sit in the moment. Sometimes things can happen so quickly and so fast that everything's a blur. But I want you to take in this very special moment as you prepare to take this next step. You guys could just focus on each other for a moment. Darryl, this woman whom you hold by the hand, she's about to be your wife. I mean, think about it. This is the girl that you went to junior high with, the girl that you went to college with, but the woman you never knew until God used a camera to give you a small glimpse at the one that you would one day marry. And Darryl, within your life and within your love, your character and your conduct, it lies much of her happiness and joy. She has given you her heart, her love, and her faithfulness. You have the ability to bring her so much joy or to cause her much heartache. And all that you offer in material things, you need to know, are of very little value. That's not why she loves you. But the practice and thoughtfulness and care as a husband which you have demonstrated during your dating relationship, that will always keep her heart one to yours forever. Jezzy, The man whom you hold by the hand, he's about to be your husband. I mean, this is the guy whom you met and who made an impact on your heart from the very start, from that first date in that college classroom of all places, where you guys chose to create a foundation, singing together, praying together, reflecting on your relationship with God together. There was something different, and you knew it. And Jezzy, within your life and within your love lies much of Darryl's help and inspiration for life. He's going to look to you for encouragement, for comfort, for confidence. And no matter what the world may say or think, no matter the difficulty or ups and downs, your life continues to be the inspiration and your love, the protection that he will need as he continues to take next steps in fulfilling his purpose in life. As the two of you prepare for your journey together as husband and wife, you have chose to write your own vows to one another. And beginning with Darryl, I'd like to invite you to share.
Jezyrose, I can remember it like it was yesterday when I first met you. I remember the day you came to NorCal to return an item that I left behind. I remember the times we were there for each other when we were both going through personal pain. I remember the night you waited for me to come back home from a trip so that we could hang out, even if it was just for a quick welcome back home. That night, as I held you in my arms, I knew you were someone I never wanted to let go. You were someone worth staying up all night talking to as we drove around eating tamales at 4 a.m. And you were worth those drives of taking you to work no matter how much I hate driving in LA. You were and are worth every moment of time spent together. You're the most beautiful, God-fearing woman I've ever met. Today marks our 3-year anniversary. Happy anniversary, love. Though it's been 3 years, God has already done amazing things, and I know he will continue to do more through us. He has already blessed me with someone better than I could have ever wanted for myself. I can't wait to grow old with you, to raise a God-honoring family, to do ministry work with you, and to create memories that will last a lifetime. I promise I will always be there for you, to be your shoulder to cry on, to rejoice with, to always take care of you, to make you laugh when you feel down, to be the man you've always prayed for. I promise to always put your needs before mine. I promise God will always be the center of our lives, our family lives, and to always seek him for guidance. I love you, Jezyrose.
Darryl, first things first, I love you so much. You were the best surprise I ever had. Even before we began our relationship, I had always loved being friends with you. I always admired you and your love for Jesus. I look back on the first day we met, the first time I saw you lead worship, and the first time I truly saw your heart for people. And I thought, man, why aren't there more guys like Darryl in the world? I had no idea that years later, I'd get to have the one and only Darryl and be standing here with you today. Oh my God. Making it known to the world that you are exactly who I was looking for and praying for. You're faithful, genuine, loving, humble, and very sacrificial. You love me not just through your words, but mostly through actions, and I can't thank God enough for bringing such a precious gift like you in my life. You show me what it's like to be truly loved, and you continuously show me what it's like to be with a man of God who strives to love his wife as Jesus loves his church. I can't believe you get to be mine and I get to marry you. You inspire me to be the best Jezyrose I can be. And you challenge me to be strong. And you love me and accept me for who I am. And that's amazing. You're also very cute and very funny, which is really great. And there's not a day where you can't make me laugh. And I learned so much from you. I am so much better at technology because of you. I especially love how positive you are, how you can look at any situation, whether good or bad, and see the good thing that God is doing through it. And I have your dad to thank for that, because I know you got that from him. I love your faith. I love that you love God. Oh my God, I'm sorry, this is really long. I love your dedication in ministry. And whether it's through music or working on a project or making cool things together, I love the way that we can complement each other in life. And I'm convinced that God brought us together for such a time as this to bring others closer to him. And one thing I pray for our marriage is that it would be one where God gets to do what he wants to do. A marriage full of love while also fully surrendered to the one who made us. It took a journey for us to get here, and I'm beyond happy, not just because we're surrounded by the people we love who've helped us get here, but because it's you, and it's always been you. You were absolutely worth the wait. So Darryl, I love you, and I'm so excited to spend my life with you. I've never been more proud to be part of a family like the Boediarto family. And with God as our witness, I promise to be the best wife I can be. Whether you're making music for the Lord or making moves, winning on those video games that you do, I will always be by your side cheering you on. I promise to be faithful and true, to be there when you need me, just as you always have been with me, to always hope with you even when times get rough, to partner with you and to always take care of you. I promise to always love you with everything I have, no matter what. And as I promised your dad, I vow to stay with you forever. I love you.
Thank you, God. Jezzy let him know. That's right. So did Darryl. So good to hear you guys share from your heart. I'm going to ask you guys to hold each other by the hand in this moment. And Darryl, I'm going to ask that you just please take a moment to repeat after me. Jezyrose, I take you as a gift from the hand of God to be my wedded wife. And I promise in the presence of God and these friends and family to be your loving and faithful husband. In weakness and in strength, sickness and in health, good times or bad, through tears and laughter, whether rich or poor, no matter the outcome, with God's help, as long as we both shall live. Thank you. Jezzy, I'd like you to repeat after me as well. Darryl, I take you as a gift from the hand of God to be my wedded husband. I promise in the presence of God, these friends and family, to be your loving and faithful wife. In weakness and in strength, sickness and in health, whether good times or bad, through tears and laughter, whether rich or poor, no matter the outcome, with God's help, as long as we both shall live. I'd like to ask you both, what token do you give as a symbol of your marriage, your love, commitment, and faithfulness today? Rings. Take those. Okay. Cool. Today, you both determined to seal your vows by the giving and receiving of a wedding ring. And the wedding ring is simply an important symbol and a sign to the world of your union today. A wedding ring is an outward and visible sign of this inward and spiritual grace, signifying to all that you two have become one in marriage. The precious metal is symbolic of the purity of your love, as well as your love and devotion to one another. And the infinite circles that they form are to remind you that your marriage lasts forever and never, ever ends. And understanding this, Jezzy, will you receive this ring from Darryl as a token and of his affection, his sincerity, as well as his faithfulness? And will you wear it as a symbol of your affection, sincerity, and faithfulness? Darryl, you can take the ring. Darryl, as you place the ring on Jezzy's finger, please repeat after me. This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
In token and in pledge.
In token and in pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
Darryl, will you also receive this ring from Jezzy as a token of her affection, sincerity, and her faithfulness? And will you wear it as a symbol of your affection, sincerity, and faithfulness?
I will.
Jezzy. As you place the ring on Darryl's finger, please repeat after me. This ring I give you. Yeah, that one. In token and in pledge.
In token and in pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And abiding love. Let's join hands together. Would you bow your heads with me one more time? Heavenly Father, we thank you once again for the privilege, Lord, to take in this moment together with Darryl and Jezzy. And Father, this is a holy moment. They have spoken vows of marriage, Lord, not just in front of us as friends and family, but Lord, they've spoken these vows directly to you. Father, they are choosing to honor this marriage union which you have created. And so God, we pray in the name of Jesus, Lord, that your hand would be upon them. Lord, that you would watch over them, that you would strengthen them, that you would encourage them. Father, we pray that you would continue to lead them and guide them all the days of their life. Lord God, in good times, in bad times, Lord God, Lord, in the twists and turns of life, Father, I pray that they would find you ever present. Lord God, that you are a constant, that your love, it never ends. And Father, as they lean into your love for them, God, I pray that their love for one another would continue to grow and flourish. Lord, we pray blessing upon them, God. We pray your protection over them. We pray for your provision and your favor, God, as they continue to lean into you, to trust you, and as they take this new journey as husband and wife. Father, we give you glory and we give you all the praise and honor that you deserve for this incredible moment on this special day. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen and amen. Based on the vows that you two have both given to each other, as well as the giving and receiving of rings, I now, by the authority vested in me in the state of California, as well as the church, as a minister of the gospel, I do hereby pronounce that you today are now husband and wife in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. And Darryl, I'd like to invite you to kiss your bride. Yeah, in front of everybody. I like it. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very, very proud to present to you today Mr. and Mrs. Darryl Boediarto.
A star across my sky, just like the angel off the page, you have appeared into my life. Feels like I never be the same, just like a song in my heart, just like the oil on my hands. Oh, I do love you. Still wonder why it is I don't argue like this with anyone but you. We do it all the time. It's blowing out my mind. I'm lost without to know that I love you, baby. Lost without you, can't help myself. How does it feel to know that I love you, baby? You got this look I can't describe. You make me feel like I'm alive when everything is so faint. Without a doubt, you're by my side. You are a blessing in my life, a gift of love that he provides. Oh, I love you. So wonder why it is I don't argue like this with anyone but you. We do it all the time, it's blowing out my mind. I'm lost without you, can't help myself. How does it feel to know that I love you, baby? I'm lost without you, can't help myself. How does it feel to know that I love you, baby?
Thank you so much for tuning in to the celebration of Darryl and Jezyrose. We hope you guys are having a good time. We want you to do us a favor. As you are celebrating, as you're watching, some of you guys might have gotten dressed up. Please post the pictures on social media using the hashtag #TheBoediartos so we can see how you celebrated with us online. And without further ado, we're going to make some noise in this room. But what I need you guys to do online is I want you to hit up the comment section with your well wishes, with some emojis. Do it as much as you want. We're going to make some noise in this room to bring on the beautiful couple that we're celebrating. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, for the first time making their public appearance, Mr. and Mrs. Jezyrose and Darryl.
Come on, let's hear it. Stand your comments. Come on, let's hear the emojis. Yeah. Keep it going, y'all. Come on.
Of you and the way you With your smile so warm and your cheeks so soft, there is nothing for me but to love you. And the way you look with each word, your tenderness grows, tearing my fears apart. Yeah, that laugh that wrinkles your nose.
Hi everyone, hope you're having an awesome day. Just want to introduce myself real quick. If you didn't know, I'm Jezyrose's cousin, Ria May, aka her cousin, aka her sister, aka as well, one part of the Tres Marias in our family. So just a little background. In our family, we are always, the three of us are always together, us three girls, and we've just been inseparable since we were little. And so, all our family members just call us Tres Marias. So yeah, we're part of that. I've known Jezyrose for most of my life. One of my first ever memories of her was when we were little. I went to the Philippines and she was still living there. And she was 9 years old and she was like, "You never played this game before?" And she was showing me how to play jackstones. You know those like little rubber balls? She would like show me like, "Look, come over here." And like, we ever since then, she's like teaching me random things little. And we've always like get into trouble together as well. It's just, we have a lot of history. And ever since she came to the US, we were this one memory I wanted to share with everyone. This one time we actually got into trouble playing archaeologists in our aunt's front yard. And so we were thinking like, oh, it'd be a good idea to mix like perfume and a little powder together and put it on our aunt's walls, thinking it wouldn't stain, you know? And so we did that. And then our cousin came out and he's like, "Oh, you guys are in trouble." And like, as you can see, like we just went to weird random things. Of being kids, quoting friends, getting into Korean dramas, to our midnight escapades, creating songs, and now you're starting a new life with the man that God has created to be beside you. I'm just so happy for the both of you. You have such a big heart and you're so beautiful inside and out. Ever since you were little, you have been creating songs. I always looked up to her as my big sister. And just seeing the both of you all together, just, I remember the first time that you talked about Darryl. We're always in her car, by the way. It's not when we have our deep talks. And this one time, we were in her car late at night, probably 2 a.m. or so, and she's telling me about Darryl, and I know him, but as a friend. And then she was telling me, I remember, he's different, this one's different. And ever since then, just the way she shines whenever she talks about you, and the way that you shine when you talk about her. Oh my gosh, I'm emotional, sorry. Oh gosh, not trying to cry, but the both of you, I'm just so happy for the both of you. You guys have such big hearts, hearts of service, God-fearing man. I'm just so happy that God has placed you in her life. And just one quick thing too I wanted to say, Darryl, that you are now officially part of the Filipino family. Welcome. And ever since the first time, just wanted to put this in, that ever since he started making jokes in our family and I found out he's so funny, I was like, we're gonna get along. This is the one for her, yeah. But you guys are just so beautiful and I'm so happy. I made a whole speech and I feel like I'm ad-libbing because it's just coming out. But I want everyone to raise a glass with me to my new Darryl, to my new brother Darryl. To my new brother Darryl, welcome to the family. I'm so happy that we have you, that you have each other. To Jezyrose, my sister, I love you so much, and I know you've been dreaming about this day ever since, a long time, with all our night times of talking about all of your life of just like, I wonder when it's going to be. And it is today that you are together with him. And I'm just so excited for your marriage. And I pray that you continue to serve one another. Look to God as the center for everything. Serve one another. I just love you guys. And to the happy couple, I love you. Cheers.
Alrighty. Hello, everyone. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Marissa, and I'm one of Jezyrose's maid of honors, as well as her baby cousin. I know a lot of people usually start off with how they met the bride, but as far as I can remember, this beautiful woman has always been a part of my life. And as long as I've known her, she has always been such an amazing role model. I've always admired her because of how genuine, how hardworking, how incredibly talented, how committed she is for the things she loves and the people she cares for. I looked up to her a great deal since I was a little girl, but because we were a few years apart, and I'm not gonna say how much because I'm scared to say right now, I've always felt a little shy around her because I mean, I wanted to be like her. But as we grew up, we got so, so much closer, and the three of us eventually, like Atharia said, we became the family's Tres Marias, the new generation of the Tres Marias, who were known to be found singing in every single family bathroom in existence and in every family hallway. It's always been such an incredible adventure with you, especially when we have our cousin nights and you're the one driving. you're one of the most amazing people I've ever met and had the privilege of growing up with. You've always believed in people, and because of that, I'm so thankful for it because you believed in me. It's truly because of you that I was able to unlock certain passions in my life and pursue those loves. You're the one who always pushed me. I remember you giving me singing homework to improve on my singing when I was like, I don't know, 7? You were teaching me how to do riffs. She was like, you better do this in like 2 weeks. I was like, I'll try. You were there when I first learned my first guitar chord. The three of us would always write songs, but to be honest, it was them writing songs and I would just have fun singing it. You taught me how to harmonize. You're the reason why I fell in love with entertainment, and you drove me to my very first dance audition. You were there to celebrate that first step, and today I'm so happy to be able to celebrate this big day with you in person. There's so, so much more to say about you and to you, but just know I'm so happy for the love you found with Darryl. And speaking of Darryl, first off, I want to officially welcome you into this Filipino family, even though you've been one of us for a while. I remember when I first found out you were dating my cousin, and I was like, who's that? But after meeting you and getting to know you a little more, I just knew you were the one for me at the Jezyrose. The love you both have for music, for family, for community, for God, everything just lined up so perfectly. And knowing your guys' story, looking back, I'm not sure any of us knew that this was going to happen, but God did. He had your story planned out from the very beginning, and I'm so amazed by that. The Lord brought you two together, and here we are celebrating your marriage today. My prayer to you both is that you continue to love and lift each other up during this new journey of your lives. Remember that love is patient, love is kind, and love never fails. It may not always be easy, but always remember His love and the love you have for one another. And you'll always get through anything and everything that gets in your way. I love you both, and I'm so incredibly happy and excited for this new chapter of your story. With a ton, ton of love and happiness, here's to you, bride and groom. Woo! Love you.
Testing, there you go.
Hi, my name is Jedrick, and I'm lucky enough to be one of Darryl's best men. It still amazes me to think that Darryl, who's honestly the most sociable and energetic person that I know, would choose me to be his best man. But I'd like to start by saying how truly happy I am for the both of you guys. I still remember when he described his ideal type to me. So when he told me that he found someone that checks off every single check mark on his list, I was like, yes! So when do we get to meet her? That's what we always did with Darryl, because Jen and I always pestered him and always looked after him. Some of you may know that Darryl doesn't like to share much about his personal life, and that he likes to keep things to himself. But when he started talking to me about his relationship with Jezzy, I literally had to take a step back. Wait, is he really talking to me about his relationship? And that's when I knew that this person that he's with is someone who is truly special to him. She is Darryl's kryptonite. Now, to list one of his best qualities, aside from his dad jokes, is that he's a great listener. This is your best quality to give to Jezzy, Darryl. Where am I? Darryl has not only helped me through some of my troubles in life, but I know that he's been there for many of the youth kids at my old church. He was the go-to person to talk to when they faced struggles in life or lost sight of God. And as sad as it is to say, I have to give you to Jezzy. I have to give you up. But I know that she will love you and cherish you every day. I know that you'll make her smile just like you do for the many of us in this room. So again, I'm happy to call you my brother. And I'm truly happy for the both of you. So everyone, can you please join me in raising a glass to the newlyweds?
Check. All right. I'm sorry, I'm not high tech. Good afternoon to all. This is an extraordinary day for my wife and I to welcome Darryl Boediarto together with his mom, Mrs. Marta Leticia Boediarto, and family into our family. With this special mention to the most important person to the family, Win Boediarto, who is now with our Creator. Thank you all for being here and trusting that this special event will be safe and joyful to all of us. When I came to know Darryl, I realized that he is the best partner for my daughter, because I can see in him how he was raised by his parent. He put God first in everything he does, knows how to respect others, very responsible in times of needs, and very faithful to Jezyrose. Am I right? When time flies so fast, yeah, my baby girl is now married. I can vividly remember when we first came here in California, Jezyrose is just a simple, little skinny who is very curious about everything. She's very thoughtful, especially during occasions. I cannot forget the first that she didn't have money to buy us a gift for our wedding anniversary. She woke up so early and prepared a breakfast for us to celebrate, set up the table nicely, and created a unique card for us. Although the food was a little bit burned, my wife and I ate them all quietly and celebrate our special occasion merrily. We always pray to God that she will be able to meet a guy who can protect her, love her dearly, and be faithful to her at all times. Then one day, surprisingly, Darryl was introduced to us. Now, all I can say is that I am so proud for both of you. After all you have been through, I know you deserve all the happiness. Cherish one another at all times. When both of you feel that you are busy, never forget to go on date and reminisce the first time you met. And always put Christ as the center of your relationship, so that God will continue to bless both of you all the days of your lives. Thank you, and good afternoon to all.
everybody. So me and my dad, we're really awkward dancers. So for our father-daughter thing, instead of doing a father-daughter dance, we wanted to do a father-daughter song. It's something that we love doing together, and it's something that I always grew up doing with my dad, is just singing together. So although we haven't really practiced this very much, here we go. Times you stood for me, for all the truth that you made me see, for all the joy you brought to my life, for all the wrong that you made right, for every dream you made come true, for all the love I found in you. I'll be forever thankful, Daddy. You're the one who helped me up, never let me fall. You're the one who saw me through it all.
It seems like yesterday, the time has gone so fast. Now my baby's all grown up, but the memories will last. It's hard to say goodbye when you've always been so near. But for now, I hold you tight, like those times I hold you dear.
You were my strength and I was weak. You were my voice when I couldn't speak. You were my eyes when I couldn't see. You saw the best that was in me. Lifted me up when I couldn't reach. You gave me faith cause you believe. I'm everything I am because you love me.
When you were young, I used to laugh at the funny things you say. Right now, I just can't help but smile on this blessed day. As we sing, I keep our love deep within my heart. Thank God for giving me this angel in my arms. You're my little angel, so baby, don't you cry. It's time to spread your wings and fly. If there's one thing this father knows, the hardest part's letting go, but you will still always be daddy's little angel.
All those times you stood by me, for all the truth that you made me see.
Daddy's little
all those
angel.
Times you stood by me, for all the truth that you made me
your
see.
Your daddy's little angel.
Love you, Daddy.
From a cloud and angels' wings.
Now that you've come
Well, first off, I just want to thank everyone who came here, and especially for taking that test. I know it wasn't fun for some people, but no, honestly, guys, thank you for just being there in our lives and always being there to support us. We love you guys. We just love you guys so much. We're so glad you guys were here to celebrate this special moment in our lives. And man, I'm just truly so grateful for every one of you. I love you guys. And now I'm going to pass to Jesse.
Thank you guys all for coming. And also speaking to the people that are watching online, thank you so much for tuning in. We know this isn't the traditional way of doing weddings, and I know it's a little bit different, but we just so appreciate all the support and the love that you guys have shown us and poured out on us. I mean, being here, even say, like Darryl said, taking the test, or all of you guys that are here with us in person, we can't thank you enough for all that you've done and sacrificed for us, all your help, Christina. Oh my gosh, thank you for making our signs and everything. You're amazing, and I'm so excited to be your sister. And we want to thank Jae for helping us out with everything, putting things together and making things happen for today. You're awesome, girl. Thank you. We love you. We want to thank Pastor Jack and the Sheets family for being with us and tracking along with us in our relationship and helping us be the better couple or equipping us for a better marriage. Thank you. And the Maulits. I'm not saying that right, huh? Maulits. Thank you. Thank you so much for everything that you do for us and for the advice that you give us, for always thinking of us and for all the food and the wonderful things that you do. We love you guys so much. Thank you for being here. Ate Christine and Nevaeh, thank you for singing for us with your beautiful voices. We love you guys so much. Thank you for being part. I'm just going to go down the line. Thank you, Steph and Tim and Jed and Jay again for being here. I know that, you know, it's a little tough and it's been somewhat uncomfortable for everybody too, but just you being here just shows a lot of your love and support for us, and we thank you so much. Thank you for being here, setting up and taking care of everything too, and helping Jay. Tia Lupe, thank you. He tells me I don't say Tia right, like, oh, thanks, Tia. Thank you for being here. We love you, and I'm so glad you're able to represent the Espinoza family. Thank you so much for your love and support as well. And my mom and my dad, you guys are wonderful. We love you so much. Thank you for all your support, for helping us when we were in quarantine too, for taking care of us, for blessing us with so much. You have been so wonderful, and I really can't thank you enough for bringing me up, and you're wonderful parents, honestly. You really are, and I don't say that enough. Thank you so much for all that you do. Mom and Dad, we love you. We love you so much. And I can't express enough how happy I am to be a part of your family, the way that I've seen you be so strong is such an inspiration to me, and I'm so excited to be part of the Boediarto family. Thank you for welcoming me with open arms. Thank you for making me part of your family from the get-go. You and all of the wonderful meals that we shared together. I always, always loved your cooking. Thank you. Thank you for being here. Ria and Marcel's the maid of honor, and Marissa, for all that you did. You guys, you helped me so much with everything. And Marissa put together our wonderful bridal suite and groom suite, which was so beautiful, right? Thank you, Marissa, for all your time and effort, for making me feel like the best friend ever. And Marcel and Ria, I know that it's been difficult with us being far apart, but you made so much effort to make me feel like such a wonderful bride, to make me feel so special with all the wonderful distant virtual things that you did. And I just went down the line, but Leena, I love you, Leena. Thank you so much for being here. You made all this happen, and your music skills and your audio skills. Thank you for keeping us together. And Garrison and Lisa, we love you guys so much for all your support. Gabby, for being here too. Man, you guys are amazing videographers and photographers, and we are so honored that you would say yes to to capture our special moment. We love you guys so much. I love you. Thank you for all that you are and all that you do. I took the whole thing. I'm sorry. But
She's better at speeches than I am. We all know that.
No, not really. I just ramble. But thank you guys again. Thank you for tuning in. We love you. And we hope that we can celebrate together in person for part two soon. Bye.
For Darryl and Jesse, congratulations on your wedding. I love you guys. Darryl, you always be my best son. I always love you. I always take good care of you. But always remember when you were young, when we were together, when we have all the, our happiness together. And I love you both, Jesse and Carol. And congratulations on the wedding. And always be together with God, with our family. And hopefully, I'll be home soon too. I love you. I love you.